Ah, there we go. Mic is muted. Hey, man.
Hi. You can hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Awesome. Okay. Good. How are you?
I'm goodish. I've been doing a lot of homework and shit lately, though.
Okay, I see.
Uni life. Uni, long time, out of days.
Okay, let me see. I think we go into that one first. Okay. One of the games you sent me, or not sent me, but which I downloaded, was a very, very wild TVP, very strange one on New Gettysburg, where he turtled like crazy and you were like up 100 supply.
Yeah. That was the game that I tried saying, yeah, don't bother with that one.
Yeah.
I just saw the victory and I was like, oh. And then I couldn't remember what type of game it was, but when you described it to me, I was like, oh yeah, that game. That was a weird game.
It was really strange.
I don't even know what he was planning.
I first thought because of the cannons, man, this guy is playing the Golden Armada style, and this can be so strong. But then he went into three gates and blink and never made any probes and lost the pylon, and suddenly you were up 100 supply, and that was so weird.
Yeah, I was like, I asked him after the game if he had like a hidden base or a proxy or something. I watched the replay and he had no hidden bases or anything like that. So I'm still even more confused.
Yeah, that was really strange. Okay, so let me open the build order to check it shortly. Blop 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 blop. Do you play the CC first on like every map?
Nah, just Apotheosis.
Okay.
I play it on Frost if I ever play that, but I've got that vetoed.
Okay. Wow, 100 supply at the 6 minute mark. That's really strong. Normally you are on 100 supply at the 7 minute mark, even if you trade, so... But with command center first, yeah. So the early minutes are looking quite decent. So far, no major mistakes or anything big I have to talk about.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of minor stuff that I still know about, but it's sort of just like...
Oh,
it's things that I do every now and then.
Okay, so now I know why you didn't scout the gas. Your SCV got killed. That's a pity. Because now you know basically nothing. You don't even know where...
I knew he would be on two gas because of... I assumed he would be on two gas because of the robo.
Yeah, sure. But you weren't able to scout the pylon positioning, so any scan could miss some important part. You know, if you go in, for example, with a Reaper or your SCV, you wanna check the, of course, Robo or Twilight, double gas, sure, but also find every pylon, so you know where it's most likely that he gets additional tech. So if you scan, you don't miss it.
Oh yeah, I strangely didn't think about that.
So you get the probe. Unfortunately, it went in, but it didn't see much. Is your stim pack on time? I think it is.
I wouldn't expect the tech to be on time.
Oh,
I haven't actually been following the build
wow.
for a while.
Oh, look at that. Okay. Okay, so 3:30 tech lab finishes. And it takes you... Oh my god, 20 seconds. So your stim is 20 seconds late. That's huge. That is huge. Okay. Okay, your eBay finishes up. You don't have enough gas currently. So it's maybe a little bit too early, but I think it's fine. Should be okay. Do you... Yeah, there you go. Okay. I was wondering if you just get the eBay for the turret or the upgrades as well. But looks good. You didn't spread at all, like, with your vision. You're completely in the dark. So you don't know if there is a nexus coming up or not.
Usually I keep my marines nearby. Like, I shouldn't be keeping that many marines nearby, but I keep them just in case of oracles.
Mm-hmm.
Because I wasn't able to get to see if they were burning Stargate. That's why I built Missile Turret at my main and then kept my the ones at my natural.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, the thing is, at least one marine or one SAV, you should check when he's getting the nexus. That is really important information for you. So he went for three gates before nexus. This is very safe. Very safe opening. And okay, with the command center first, it is a little bit different because your timing with the medivacs hits so late. But if you would, for example, play the 16 marine drop, which you can also play in TVZ, then you wanna know, is the nexus coming down at the 4 minute mark or 4:40 or even 5:10? In order to know if it's safe to drop or not. For example, against Blink, it is quite risky to drop there, especially if you went for three gates. Unless you have Bian-like micro, you most likely will just lose a lot without taking good trades.
Yeah, I wouldn't be able to take good trades on this server, because I'm pretty sure I'm playing on East US on this one, mm-hmm, which is the furthest possible server.
Yeah. So
I'm not sure if the ping is actually accurate, though. Like, I'm not sure if that's accurate for the game, or if that's just a replay thing.
I can't...
It says it's on East US.
Yeah. Okay, so the benchmark says you should be on 100 supply right now, and as you can see, you're missing quite something there. You almost are on 46 SCVs with that's really good, but somehow maybe you slip with your macros at some point a little bit, at least with the marine production, I guess.
Yeah, just playing when I'm just focused on macro, I don't usually miss building units unless it's a cost thing, like I just don't have the money at that time. And I'm also pretty good when it comes to building SCVs constantly. The problem is I tend to forget to expand, also because I either just get distracted at some point or if I don't have the money to expand when I want to.
Yeah. Okay, so one thing which you might want to start is sniping the observer. And on a normal map, if the Protoss hits his timing and went for gate, core, robo, the observer should hit roughly at 4:30. On Apotheosis, it's a bit later because the map is so big. So as you can see, he will just move in right now. That's like 20 to 30 seconds later than 4:30. But you can, I mean, you saw the robo timing. And it's not proxied, it should not be a warp prism. It's that early, it doesn't make any sense, so there has to be an observer first. And you wanna check for it. And if you scout it, that means he doesn't see what are you doing. He can't check your buildings, he can't check your army, he won't see when you move out. And like you, completely playing in the dark, you will blind him as well.
Is there an optimal setting for being able to see observers? Because I know I used to be really good at picking up observers back when I started at the beginning of the year, and I'm pretty sure that was just because I was playing a lot slower, so I was looking at the same screen for a lot longer.
Well, if you know the timings and the position of where observer normally are, then that makes stuff a lot easier. So I don't know if there's an optimal setting. I just zoom in with the mouse wheel. There are guys who are shifting the camera, like a little bit to the left, to the right, switching it around.
I have heard that people used to do that a lot, but it's lost favor. I never really did it.
Okay. Well, I go in with the mouse wheel because it's quite fast, and for me it works most of the time. But what do I do?
Do it randomly or like?
No, that's the thing. If you start to do it randomly, just look. You got two bases. Imagine how many screens you would to randomly check. That's like 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 screens. And then maybe multiple times because you won't see it that fast. No. You need to know where the observer will be. And that means, the observer at 4:30 will hit most likely your natural first. In like 90 to 95% of all cases, it will hit your natural first. So if you know that timing, you can save your scan just a little bit, see is it coming or not. On apotheosis, of course, 20 seconds to 30 seconds later, snipe it. And if you miss it, the observer can be on top of your army. It can be like a little bit outside of your base to see any move out, or it can be on top of your production. Those are those three spots where normally an observer would be. Okay. At your base. And then you can check those three shortly in between your macro, and then snipe it if you see it. If you don't see it on Diamond, not every Protoss gets the observer. Even on Master, some just miss it out completely. So don't bother around. I wouldn't throw a safety scan. That's expensive. If you don't find it, then you don't find it. Potentially it's not there. I see even pros just throwing down a safety scan there. Of course, it's not that bad for them because they have such good macro. But still, if there is no observer, if you don't see it, in most cases there is none. Or it's at a spot where you won't see. I mean, if he would have this observer, if you go on your vision, now you can see it. If you press V button, for example, on your army, then you see the blur. But if you would have parked the observer like an overlord on top of the platform there, then you won't see it, I guess. Mm. Even the blur, you won't see it. So you would need the medivacs first, and they don't go there currently. So that's the thing. If you don't see it, it can be on a platform, but most likely there is none where you're looking, because you will see it if you have sharp enough eyes then. And as you said, you were good with the observer sniping back then, so you know how it's looking. Yes, and with the observer, the same thing what he wants to do is, the same thing he's doing you want to do as well. Generate vision. So with the SCV or the Marine at the third base, at the 4-minute mark, just one, it's enough. It's not a big commitment, but you will know, is there something going up? If you would play Reaper, then of course don't try to lose the Reaper and have it parked there. On the other hand, you want to scout his main base between 3:30 and the 4-minute mark as well to know what's coming with the Reaper if you have one.
Yeah.
So that's difficult. Sometimes you can get in with the scouting and don't lose the Reaper, but that's most of the cases you go in and you lose the Reaper and then you need some Marine or SCV there in order to spot it. The worst thing which can happen if you don't scout for the third base is if you do for example the 60 Marine drop, you drop out, you go out with your two medivacs, and like 30 seconds later a warp prism hits you with Dark Templar. And then it's most likely instant GG because your army is out of position, potentially you don't have scans even, and then even if you have scans, there is not much at home to defend. So you need to know, is he committing to a nexus or not? And if there is no nexus at the 4-minute mark or 4:15, let's say, then I wouldn't drop at all. It's super risky. Just generate vision and try to figure out what is he up. What is he doing? If he's getting his nexus just at the 5-minute mark and you didn't deal any damage so far, that's okay. Because of your macro, he did damage to himself. He went defensively, you never committed, and he punished himself by not playing as greedy as he could.
Okay.
That's what I would do. And if he goes then with the nexus, you can decide, do I push out now, depending on what you see, what you scout with his army, maybe a scan can confirm what is he doing. Or you can go your third command center yourself. at roughly the same time. It would be really early. Bjorn, for example, gets his command center between 6:30 and the 7 minute mark in most games, not in every game, but in most games, which is really late if you think about it. But because he's dealing so much damage and so much pressure with his 2-1-1 setup, he can do it. It depends. I would say go with macro. Especially on this game, I managed to see you almost. It took you forever to go on to 5 racks. So let's see what happens right now. First of all, did he see the medivacs? Okay, that's sad. But not the biggest issue here. So he sees it, and you decide to push because you didn't see anything. You didn't know. I assume you thought he would go for the gold phase. And now you stay right here, and this position is nearly unpushable. Especially with sentries. His reaction is really slow, so that's why you went through. But just imagine those force fields would split your army at the rocks and the platform. Yeah. It would have been so bad for you.
It would have been worse if they got stormed as well.
Yeah, especially then.
I snapped them like a... I think so... I did a lot of sniping of the things.
Mm-hmm. This game. Yeah, that's really good. If you can manage to do this, pop the barrier of the immortal, also really nice. The Liberator, yeah, that's the thing. It took them so long to siege up. Yeah,
they were bound to my main army, so when I tried to move my marines back, they Liberators uncued their siege mode.
The fun part is, you still traded better. You. Mineral wise, you lost quite the same. Like, you only lost 50 minerals more. But gas wise, you killed 600 gas more than he killed. And you saved your medivacs. So, even this trade was really bad. Potentially, you could have won right there with better execution. Yeah. Or at least trade his army and kill his third nexus. Stuff like that. But even then, you did quite well in terms of trading. But, and that's the sad part, behind that, you never went for your third command center, up to 5 barracks. Your eBay and your armory are missing because your plus 1 armor will finish up soon as well. And you would have money for all of that. Especially because if you look at your tech lab barracks, there are 200 more minerals waiting, doing nothing. So you would be on 1.2k minerals and 700 gas, which is enough to go command center, 2 more barracks, and eBay and the armory.
Yeah.
So I guess that you definitely need to focus more on macro. It would have helped a lot. Those barracks could be finished right now as well as the other stuff. Maybe even the add-ons could be potentially done, I guess. And that would be such a good boost to your macro. Because he's still on 3... No, he's on 6 gates now. That's the thing. Look, he's on 6 gates, and you're only on 3 barracks. So he can outproduce you, but he got the stronger units. And that's bad.
Yep.
And what you could try to do in TVP, TVC as well... But most likely in TVT, of course, is to have marines like on the pathways where he could come and on the bases where he would take his next base. Just to know what's going on.
Yeah, something I've been trying to do, but it's just something I keep forgetting.
Yeah, it's really hard. So I just write down generate vision because you don't want to play blind folded. If you know what's coming, or when it's coming, you have such a good reaction time. Just imagine a marine standing there, and one there, and if he moves out, you have like 30 seconds to react. That means you could potentially throw down 3 bunker if you need them, which is such a great boost to your defense. But if you just see it when he is there, then it's way too late. Oh, those storms hit hard. Ooh. Those storms do really hit hard. And you're not really constantly using your starport and your factory. So do you have those in the same group as the barracks or in different groups? Control group
They're
wise.
In the same.
In the same, okay.
They're in the same group.
Okay, so maybe just get used to use the tabulator. Or the I don't know if you use the tabulator tab for shifting through, switching through the production facilities.
Yeah, I use tab. And yeah.
Because so in the best case you wanna have, especially in TVP, all your structures produce nonstop. Like the factory, widow mines or tanks depending on how you want to play, the starport, medivacs, and later on liberator of course, and the barracks nonstop stuff. And you still like we are now 3 minutes advanced from the last time, and you still have only 3 barracks. And now there are 4 marauder queued in 1 barracks. Normally, at that time, you could have been on 8 racks.
Yeah.
So, eight racks. I would say with 3 reactor and 5 tech lab. 1 factory and 2 starport. That would be ideal, I guess. Here, so you have 1 medivac and 2 liberator at a time. If you're losing medivacs, you need to, of course, to replenish them. In this game, you didn't lose any medivacs. That's really impressive. That's so good. So keep it up, definitely keep it up. Not losing the medivacs. You could have repaired them at some point, but still, it's good.
I think I felt like I usually do repair them if they're at base, but mm-hmm. I thought I wanted to keep pressure up because I knew I was fine.
Yeah. The thing is, and that's the fun part, with your pressure you're doing quite a good job. Oh, that hurts. Just imagine you would have had the 8 racks production and like quadruple the amount of units you currently have to pressure. So you could pressure even better. Mm. I think if he still doesn't have Link. It's really sad. You could have won this so easily with just better macro, but you stick on 3 racks like the entire game, it feels like. And that's really sad. Oh, you also don't want to mule the gold base. Always mule normal bases.
Okay, why is that?
The mules don't mine much more from the gold bases. So they mine, I guess it's like 30 or 25 or whatever it's currently now. They mine more than the SCV. So, but they mine the same amount from a gold base than they do from the normal base. So what it means is the your gold base just depletes faster.
Okay.
And then you need to retake it another base again. And basically, it's enough to have the marine the SCVs mining at the gold base because they mine faster and the mules don't benefit from the gold base, so we just throw them at the blue base.
I didn't know that. I assumed that they'd benefit from the gold.
It was
well.
In the Wings of Liberty beta, so it's long, long time ago.
Yeah.
Okay, so now that's good. So now you know, don't mine from the gold base with mules. I mean, if you are in a haste and then you do 1 or 2 mules, it's okay. But generally speaking, mule, you can see that this base would be perfect for muling. There are no SCVs. Those 6 or 7 mules would love to mine there. They would love to mine there.
This is also something I've been doing lately. That's been working out really well.
Oh yeah,
just
it's
every
awesome.
Now and then going to undefended bases with a double widow mine drop.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like that. I really like that. And now exactly that happens. He's at your doorstep and you didn't know the entire time. Just now you realize, oh wow, there's a huge freaking army coming at my way. What do I do?
Yeah, and the annoying part was I could have taken it if I wasn't here.
Yeah.
If I was on top of the ramp, I would have been fine.
No. Yeah. And you would have had time if a Marine would have stood. Even there, that would have been enough time. Here would be better, of course. Faster to see it. Yeah, and then that's just GG, I guess. Even though he has no upgrades and you are on 2-1, so you have 3 upgrades ahead.
Yeah, that was one of the things that really bothered me about this game. It was 0-0.
But he just had more stuff, you know? More stuff. Finally, you had some barracks added, but it's way too late. Like, 5 to 6 minutes too late, I would say. And you could have won this easily, with constant production out of the starport and more facilities being used. Yeah, I totally understand that feeling. It really hurts.
Yeah.
So yeah, in this game, basically, macro vision generating, Stim was 20 seconds late. So general macro, it's what the game plan is good, especially with the double Widowmine drop to deny. I mean, those Widowmines killed 18 probes. That's amazing. It's really awesome. If you can, and your pressure looks solid as well. Just your macro and your timings, the transition when to get additional facilities is way off. I mean, if you see at the end of the game, your barracks had 5 Marauder queued in. That's not good at all. Normally, at maximum 2 cycles, so one currently producing and the next one. If you are queuing up more, then that's not good.
Yeah.
So instead, just get more production facilities. It would be okay if you go up to 10 racks or even 12. If you just spend your money constantly, whatever helps you. Later on, you can reduce it again to like 10 barracks or even then the 8. If your macro is on point, then you don't even have the money to supplement them. But so long for now, get more. As if I would coach a Zerg player and he would struggle with injects, I would say go for 2 macro hatcheries or even 3. It doesn't matter. Get the larva, spend it, and if you get better with your injects, then you can reduce the amount of macro hatcheries you have again. And the same is for Terranus Protoss as well. If a Protoss can't constantly warp in or hits the timing he needs, then he needs to get more gates. It helps. It's not the best solution, but to get used to it, to spend your money, it will win you games. And then you can advance from it. Okay, let's see what we find here as well. I think the TVC you won, but I'm not sure. Let's see how TVC is looking.
There were 2 TVCs. One was a 3 racks, which I lost, and one was, I believe it was a 2-1-1. I don't remember exactly how it went, though.
Mm-hmm. Okay. No, that's fine. Let's see the 2. I think that is the 2-1, as almost nobody is going
to 3 racks. I did it differently, though, because of the map. I like to just hold off the drop and go in with the 2 tanks.
I see.
And then abuse this.
Oh, yeah. If they don't kill it, then that's so nasty.
Because I saw Innovation do that sort of style.
Mm-hmm.
The 2-1-1, except he did it with tanks.
Yeah.
Slightly later. And it was really strong.
So I don't really know what he was doing with this drone at all. Like, that's so weird.
Yeah, that could have been in my base, but whatever.
Yeah, for blocking, it's also way too early. I mean, he's losing so much mining with it. And he doesn't even block you there at all. I mean, wow. Oh yeah, I see you know the trick. That's nice. I think pulling that SCV was a little bit... okay, the barracks is still fine. Never mind. It's okay. Timing is there. The Reaper would have been fine to kill it, but it's okay. You perfectly hit the timing. You are using, I think I saw you are using the supply depot, the idle worker trick.
Yeah,
awesome.
And then after about 4 or 5 minutes, depending on the build, I switch to, about 2 or 3 idle builders.
Yeah.
That's, I still get good. Supply capped every now and then, which is annoying.
Yeah, you just need to work a little bit on the timings, when to start and such, but it's good. In Legacy of the Void, it's a little bit more different because Terran economy has changed with the mule and the 12 worker start. So sometimes you don't, if you if you go for the 2-1-1 and suddenly throw it on double eBay, you don't suddenly you don't need two supply depots at a time. That's the fun part. For now, I would say at 40 supply, you need to start double supply depot if you play this build. So right now you would need double supply depot production to start it at your natural wall off. And if you then when your medivacs move out and you hit the timing and with the double e-base, then suddenly you are not producing that much anymore. And then you suddenly don't need double supply depot for some time, especially because you get the third base up, which will help as well with the supply caps. And after that, I think you then need to restart double supply depot. It's a bit weird, so it's not as crisp as it was in Heart of the Swarm, sadly. What I don't know is...
I messed up the... I didn't saturate the second gas straight away, so I went for double widow mine because my starport was later.
Oh, yeah, I was wondering why don't you hit the timing at all. Like with the eBay, also the eBay was quite strange. The one eBay in TVC, you can normally go with double eBay, totally fine.
I also, something I've been doing when I do this build, when I do it properly, is I'd send out the two medivacs empty.
Oh, okay.
And I hope that, because sometimes when you send the two medivacs out, they'll try to do an instant counter.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Or at least if I hover it over their mineral lines, they might over respond and spam out units.
Yeah, I see. Well, normally the wall you produce is a little bit strange. The build I know is, first of all, you start the supply depot next to the gas, which is good, but then you go to for the full ramp. And you could wall off between your main ramp, main base ramp, and the refinery with like two supply depots and two e-base, I guess. Okay. And it totally hits fine. So when you move out, like 20 seconds later, you throw down the double e-bay, the supply depots are done as well. And then the wall is complete and any counter should just crush there. Depending on what he plays, if he's going for a two-base bane all-in, for example, or a big Ling Roach attack, then that's something you need to consider as well. Did you have a Reaper? Yeah, you lost a Reaper. That's okay. Okay.
Yeah, this is one of the laggy games, I'm pretty sure.
The good part is, you see what vision the Zerg did generate? It's awesome. He sees, like, everything. And that's the vision you want to take away from him eventually, and for yourself to get the vision. In TVC, it's not that important to get the vision, I would say, because you normally, in an ideal situation, you're out on the map, constantly pressuring, denying creep. So you do scouting and vision with that. But in TVC and TVT, I mean in TVP, of course, you want to have vision. And as Zerg, he wants to have the vision to know, to defend, to react, to know when he can drone up. And if you kill this vision, then he needs to gamble. Can I drone now? Is it safe? And potentially this will lead to him making more units, which is less drones. And that's what you want to achieve. So you want a Zerg to make a bunch of units that you can trade them away over and over again. Game resumed. Okay, this time you don't go with the empty medivacs as it looks like. Good kill on the Overseer. So now you try to hit the timing with the tanks as you described, right? Okay. I see. And yeah, he saw it. He's now breaking down the rocks. Okay.
Yeah, I was really happy to see that they weren't breaking down.
Okay,
usually
so...
Don't break them down straight away.
So your orbital command is finished and this little guy is blocking the orbital command, which is so annoying. So I would say if the orbital command is morphing into an orbital, the command center morphing into an orbital command, I would just grab a few marines, shift command them with attack towards the location you want to have landed it, and then back again.
Okay.
That you get, because that is so annoying. With Legacy of the Void, sure, the creep goes away faster, but still, it can happen that the orbital wants to land, you think it landed, and you didn't clear the Overlord still then you need to kill it, then you forget about it again to land it for some reason, and suddenly your command center doesn't land for 3 minutes straight in a game. So yeah. just go and kill the creep.
Getting my Overlord. Third has frequently been a late thing for me that I've been trying to work on.
Yeah.
Just finding the timing.
Yeah, so I would say if the command center finishes up and you press the orbital command button, just send some marines there. Like two, not more. If there is a huge army, you don't want to lose four or five marines, so two marines is fine. Normally there's either a circling or an overlord at best. And if there is more, then you know with the two marines and you can scout and you're fine. So two marines is enough. It's enough to push down away the overlord. If he hold commands, then you can kill it even better. And it will be in time to kill it, so the orbital can land. And again, let's see, what's with your macro? Okay, you are producing some stuff now, but most of your production facilities are idle currently. Let's have a look at the production tab, for how long the production is idle while you do this push out and micro your marines. Okay, there you go. That's not too bad. That's okay. But still, the starport and the factory are not producing. And you see it on your money, as well as the upgrades. Do you have the... Where do you put the eBay and the armory? In which control group?
Usually I don't have them hotkey.
Oh, okay. Upgrades. That's something we can improve. So okay. I would put the eBay...
Put them on 7 when I do hockey them.
We can still then improve. I would put the eBay and the armory with your command centers.
So 7 isn't a hassle for me because I have a mouse which has those.
It doesn't mean that you can't reach it. It's because you will have a better look for your upgrades if they are in the same group with the command center. If they are in the same group with the command center, normally you produce SCVs like every 12 seconds. So every 12 seconds, you will also have the E-base with you, and then you see the small white dot, which means it's still producing. And every 12 seconds you check, and if it's gone away, you know, oh, upgrades. And so there is a 12 second delay between your 1-1 upgrade finishes and you can fire up your 2-2. At best, at worst. So, instead of now, you could fire up plus 2 and it waits. But if you have it, or if you look for it the entire time, like every 12 seconds, automatically, because it's there, you look at your command center, bam. And then you know, okay, every 12 seconds. So that helps a lot to get the upgrades going all the time. Now you're pushing in and the tanks are not with your army. You still quite win this fight, which is awesome. But your third is a little bit late. And again, if you look at your barracks, there's one barracks currently producing 4 marauder at a time. And you are on 1k overmint, so just throw down another starport and 3 more barracks. So your timing on the transition, that's one thing which you need to definitely work on. If you can solve that issue, I would say you will instantaneously get like a lot better. You just have more units to work with, and that definitely helps. So now you get 2-2, awesome, he's still on 1-1. Now he gets 2-2. And he's droning up, but still, he has the awesome vision. He has like the godlike vision, he sees... If only he would have a circling right here, that would be... Then he would have, I would say, perfect vision. Yeah. If you would have a circling there, that would be perfect. At least you can try to get the watchtower all the time. They generate so much vision, it's so hard to drop at all. And because this creep spread is not the best, it definitely would help a lot to clear at least the watchtower. So even if you don't kill all the overlords, at some I rarely see it nowadays. Later, there was a time where some pros were going for a Viking to kill all the overlords.
Yeah, I do that every now and then.
It's really good. Even if they get speed overlords, it's still good to have a Viking at some point. Just squeeze it out. If it's against two base Mutalisk, I would skip it. But other than that, it definitely is worth a shot. So after you got your, if you do the push out with your medivacs and you go for the two tanks, you could skip the fourth medivac in order for a Viking. And still be able to heal most of your units and juggle around with the tanks. And it doesn't hurt you too much to skip the one medivac. Imagine this Viking would kill 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe even 5 overlords, 6 if you have good micro there. And potentially there's someone here as well. So 6 to 7 overlords you could kill, potentially. Let's say you get 3. That's still awesome. You kill 3 larva, 300 minerals. He needs to remake them. That's with the larva. And you kill vision. So this Viking definitely pays out a lot.
I didn't realize how worth that liberator was.
Did it kill so many drones?
Yeah, oh, yeah. He had really bad response times.
Interestingly, you scout the spire with the liberator.
Yeah, I scout the spire as I set it up, and I wasn't really caring about how much kills it got. I was just doing that to force attention and.
No, that's good. That's exactly how you wanna play.
This was a really good. I don't know why he tried pushing down.
I don't know either. That's the thing, the Zerg should have just gone around with half his army and sandwiched you. Instead he just tries to force his way down a ramp with 2-2 stint bio tank support. That's really, really not good for him. But still, yeah, okay, he does hold. You see your macro is just not the best there. If you can somehow fix your macro there, like you are now on that's the good thing. You are on 10 barracks, which is completely fine. They just like upgrades. I don't know if they are in the control group. Potentially not, because most of them are not producing. There you go with the add-ons finally. Do you put the barracks immediately in the control group when you produce them, or not?
If I'm looking at the screen when they're being built,
okay.
Often, like I get a whole bunch of SCVs to start building them, and I can't actually hotkey them when they're on their way to build them. Mm-hmm. So while I'm waiting for them to get to its position, I'm often doing other macro.
Okay.
Or micro.
So you should definitely go back then.
If they instantly build it, then I'll instantly just go and do it straight away.
Okay. Well, I would.
It's just a multitasking thing.
Yes. So you have two choices there. Even you somehow manage to get back to the factory's barracks like 5 seconds after you queued them up, or 10 seconds to put them in. You get used to it. That's one part. Or the other thing is you just wait for them to be built, and then put them into the group. Like, that's it, the two decisions you have right there, which I see. I would say it's better to have them in the control group and wait those 2 to 5 seconds than it is to completely forget about them and then potentially lose 2 production cycles. But it really depends on where you do feel more confident with. So the fights you take, they are quite good. You get the 3-3 upgrades now as well. That's really good. You get tanks against Roach Ravager, that's also perfect. And you deny a lot of creep stuff, so.
Here he just picks a really bad fight and it's game.
Yeah, I see. What, that one like circling.
Gave me a free concave.
Oh yeah, definitely.
So I just... I overstim, but like I don't care because mm-hmm. I just... Yeah.
Yeah, that's... He knows he's out. I mean, you killed his fourth base one time, I guess. Yeah, two hatcheries went down. And the natural, of course, yeah, so
yeah,
that's...
I kept taking this. I think I killed it twice.
Oh, awesome. And now we have 3-3 against 2-2.
With,
it's okay.
Three tank.
Yeah.
Three attack. Vehicle.
Let's have a short look at the 7-minute mark, how your macro is looking right there. Because there are those two benchmarks, which I know, are on 7-minute and 9 to 9.30.
Game paused.
Awesome. Okay, so you do hit 100 supply at the 7-minute mark. That's really good.
Okay.
Even if you would trade, like in TVP, for example, if you go for the... If you would go for the 60 marine drop and you trade all of those, potentially not losing the medivacs, still then, if you have really good macro, you can hit 100 supply at the 7-minute mark. So now you could be on potentially maybe 110, 105, but it's okay. 100 at 7-minute mark is really, really good. So there is not much you can improve there, to be honest. So that is really good already. And then let's see 9.30 to 9 minutes. Because at that point you can be maxed out. Okay,
yeah,
so...
Well, I just...
So, we do see in those... but still, even with those... those are 50 supply you lost there. Like 30 marines, a marauder, a tank, a medivac. So, 50 supply... You are basically missing 50 to 40 supply right now, which you could have had at that point, potentially. Like between 9 and 9.30, let's go to 9.30, it's not looking way better there, like, yeah, 20 supply, it's okay, but you could have done way better there. So max out at 9.30. 9.0 to 9.30. If you hit those timings, then I would always prefer macro over micro and pressure, at least up until you hit Master League. Then it's getting a bit more difficult because then you need to pressure. Otherwise, your macro won't matter as much as your opponent's. But the thing is, as Terran, you play the race which needs to pressure and deal damage, especially in TVC. Otherwise, Zerg will just run away with you, from you, with his macro. There should be no way for you to catch up in macro if you are not constantly pressuring, denying creep. At some point, he will just outproduce you heavily. That's how Zerg works, especially with Ling Bane, which is not playing right here. But
I haven't really been enjoying using the tank evac push against Ling Bane.
It's not as strong, I think, as well.
Yeah, I only really do this on ladder mm-hmm. against on this map.
Yeah.
So the rocks and how much I can abuse it. Maybe frost as well if mm-hmm. I play that map, which I usually don't.
Yeah.
And also apotheosis because I can abuse the
apotheosis is really good. Especially with the bridges, you have lots of good surface
areas. But otherwise,
areas.
I've been lately using Widow Mines instead.
Yeah.
It's
better,
well
I would say as well. I mean, with the tanks, it's you can play the two tanks against Ling Bling as well. It is strong. But if you go for the 60 marine drop, and you see there are no roaches being made at all, just queens, seven queens, and a bunch of circlings, you can assume it's not gonna be roach, and you can immediately go to Widow Mines. It works. It also works to go into those two tanks. You can juggle around and clear creep, which is awesome. So the tank evacs are awesome for clearing creep. If you drop those two tanks, scan, for example, right here. If you would be at the I think it's 6.30 where your tank evacs would be out, and you have your medivacs after your push, and you don't lose them down here, denying creep or forcing the circlings to be right there. And you have the tanks up here, scan, they will clear all the creep tumors. Tanks one-shot creep tumors. So after you landed them, they have a roughly 1 second delay, so they can shoot 5 times. One tank can shoot 5 times in a scan period. The scan lasts for, I think, 12 seconds? 9 seconds. Oh, okay. Then it was 12 in HOTS. So now it's 9 seconds, like Legacy of the Void. Okay, then it's 4 times. One tank can clear 4 creep tumor. And with 2 tanks, you can clear 8 with 1 scan. And that's not too bad.
I don't think the 2 would clear 8, though. They'd probably target the same.
If you drop them roughly behind each other, then that's not the case, actually. They target different creep tumors then.
Okay.
Just an idea of what you can do with the tanks if you against Ling Bane. As well as Roach Ravager, of course. You need to lure the army out of position and you can drop a scan there. Or you can, like on that map, for example, you can have the tanks right here as well on that edge against Ling Bane. It's awesome. The problem with tanky vags against Ling Bane is Zerglings just can close the gap so fast, and tanks attack the Zerglings instead of the Bane. So to make the tanky vags work there, you would need to split your Marines while focus firing with your tanks, making sure the tanks survive with juggling them around and micro them. It's a lot of multitasking. While Widowmines, you just burrow them and kill every Zergling near them, so the Widowmine will most likely hit the Banelings eventually. Which is way easier than with the tanks. Especially if you want to macro behind, which you are struggling currently as well. So I totally understand if you go for Widowmines there. But just for you to know, tanky vags can work as well. It's just harder. But if you would manage to make it really good to like perfectly micro it, I think tanky vags are still stronger than Widowmines. On the other hand, against Mutalists, tanky vags fall apart completely. Widowmines are just better against Mutalists, there is. Tanks are not.
Okay.
Okay. So let's jump into another game there and see what we got still left. Yeah, that was the new Gettysburg one, that was the weird one. Now let's go to Galactic Process, I think is better in this case.
I think I know this one. Yeah, he went DT.
Yes, that was the DT game. But I think he didn't do too well with the DTs, to be honest.
Yeah, I fell apart. I also didn't expect him to come so quickly. As soon as I scouted it, for some reason I thought it'd be like a little bit later.
Yeah. Okay, so there's command center first. Ooh. That was a very clutch defense there. I think if he would have committed to the SCV, he would have gotten it. Oh, he's really annoying with the pro. Just look how long he was able to delay the command center.
Yeah.
It's
very annoying with that.
It's really annoying. So for now it's not delayed. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, maybe even 10. That's so long. Yeah, I would immediately pull, like, on the command center 2 SCVs. On the barracks, however, if you pull immediately when you see the probe moving up the ramp, then you're fine with 1 SCV. But on the command center, I would pull 2. Like, this command center is so low. So late, I mean, not low. And it totally messes with your macro potentially. You didn't scout so far at all, no, wow. Yeah, that's the next thing. You totally did skip scouting because of that.
Messing me up.
Yeah, that's... And then you don't know, where are the pylons, where do I need to scan, what's coming. You didn't even know he's gone for. It could be a four gate, which is super outdated, but could be, and it would totally kill you. Oh, is this wall complete? Yes, I think it is. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
It looks a little.
Actually, I'm not sure.
No, it looks strange. No, it's not complete. There is. No, there's. I think there's one tile space between.
I think I remember thinking about that one when I was playing it. I was like, I was really confused by it.
Yeah. It looks a bit strange. Okay, still no scouting. Yeah, there's the DT shrine. I see. It went down at... 340? Yes. 340. And that's why I open up most of the time with Reaper. Because then you can jump in at 3:30. Normally you would know, okay, the Nexus is late already. Uh-oh. Because at the 4-minute mark, if he's playing Gate, Robo, and maybe Twilight, but only one Gate, then his if it's Stargate, it can be late as well, I guess. But still, at 4-minute to 4:15, a Nexus should come down. And this Nexus is late. So you would know, okay, there has to be something up. And you could jump in, scan, the Mothership Core is down there. Because he doesn't have an Adept, or did you kill it? You killed it. Perfect. And then you would be able to see the Dark Templar Shrine, and could perfectly defend. You scan now and you get lucky with the scan, which is good for you. And you can immediately react. But normally you should assume you won't see the tag with the scan. At least that's what happens for me. I'm never lucky. Never. Your turrets are up in time, however, so that's good. Oh yeah, oh no, this
thing. Yeah, this was really bad.
Yeah, you need basically to either... Okay, you had a scan. You didn't see the warp prism. So I would say instead of having all the supply depots in the back, have one at that edge and maybe one at that edge. Even though they might get sniped against Blink.
Yeah, I'm trying to do that, but sometimes I just forget.
Yeah, you just...
Like the SCVs are closer.
Or what you also can do is what would help a lot. Instead of getting the... I mean, you had the minerals. You get the turret in the mineral line, this is fine. But if you scanned and you did see the Robo and the Dark Shrine. So it's most likely to be Warp Prism. Yeah. So there would have been enough time after your scan. So there's your scan. You could have produced two turrets here as well, and just park four marines in the center between those four turrets. So if he wants to drop, he has to commit and just save a scan for the natural as well. It depends. You can also go for the turrets in your mineral lines there, but then you need to have marines. Like, if you get dropped and your marines are all at the natural, basically it's the same against Blink, I would say. Your army should be in the center between your main and your natural, like in the middle, so that you can react and have the shortest time. If your marines need to go from the ramp to the main base, that's shorter as they have to go from the natural to your main base. And those 2 to 3 seconds can make a huge difference if you need to repair the turret, for example. Or if you can catch the warp prison. Or be fast enough for Stim. If your marines would have been near the Stim, then yeah, he wouldn't have been able to kill it. Also, having the tech lab on the ramp is very vulnerable. I would have loved to see the tech lab on that barracks instead. Mm-hmm. It's safer.
Okay.
But yeah, there come the DTs. Yeah, that's so annoying. Yeah, the DTs, they dealt good damage. That's... I think you overproduce turrets as well, like that one down there is too much, and that one here should be up the ramp, I guess. position wise. I was wondering why you were pushing here without Stim. Oh no! Okay, so that push out did so much damage, which is awesome. But I guess you lost here because of one mistake.
The pylon.
Yeah, exactly. So if yeah. only you would have finished the pylon. The pylon was so low. Like the shields were gone already. And those two adepts are no threat to your 20 marines. At all.
Yeah.
So...
I realized that like right after the battles that I should have focused down the second pylon.
Yeah.
For some reason I thought... Because I didn't look straight away. I thought there'd be adepts.
Yeah.
Not adepts. DTs. And I didn't know if I had a scan.
It's so sad. I mean, your army gets completely wrecked there. That pylon, I would say you really could have dealt so much damage here. And here everything goes wrong for you. If you kill the pylon now, and then he pulls probes, then he can't fall back to the pylon at all. You can kill so much there. And then the mothership core doesn't even need to be focus fired because it has... not the best DPS, it's not the most dangerous units because there are no pylons left. That's so sad. And instead you fight into a concave in photon overcharge without Stim, without medivacs.
Yeah. If I had Stim and I focused the pylon, I was pretty sure I would have been able to win the game.
Yeah, yeah, right there, that would have been game. Or at least game ending damage. The fun part is, even though he has a third base, he is not really ahead in worker. On the other hand, your command center is very late. Like a minute late. 20 to 50 seconds late. The gases are not saturated there, okay. Oh yeah, those DTs, they are so annoying. At least you get the war prison, that's nice. So... oh yeah, and now supply blocked and suddenly 1k overmans. Throw down your barracks. You need to work on the transition.
Yeah.
That's the main part, I think, which is limiting you currently. And you go into Liberator after 2 medivacs. So I think you want to go up to 4 or 6 medivacs.
Okay.
And then Libs. At least that was the case like some months ago. To be fair, I don't see Liberator used that much in TVP anymore. Most people, most Protoss now, they seem to go Colossus Disruptor. Some are going Storm, which is also fine. Versus Storm, I would say Liberator is still very good. But against Colossus Disruptor, you can go for 2, maybe 4, but you need soon to start going for Vikings, okay. I feel like.
I haven't seen Colossus used for quite some time now, actually.
Okay. Maybe on NA it's a little bit different. I'm playing on Europe and I see a lot of those Colossus and Disruptor, and it's so difficult to play against. I mean, you need the Vikings against Colossus, but you are not allowed to overmake them. When you need perfect splits against this Disruptor, it's really... really hard, in my opinion. If you go pure Liberator with the range upgrade, yes, it's good against the Colossus as well, because they have quite the same range. But the Colossus can dance around the Liberation Zone and still hit decently your bio. While the Vikings just force out a lot of Blinkstalker, which you can basically kill with Marauder. Oh, that fight went so wrong for you, wow.
Yeah. I was one of my desperate, I need to do something.
Mm-hmm. Well, yes, he has the fourth base up. So that's the, but still, you are on 3 barracks at the 10-minute mark. And this army could be, like, a lot bigger, let's say, like 50, maybe. Not 100%. Yeah, maybe even 100%. We are hitting the 10-minute mark where you definitely could be maxed out. Even with the DTs dealing some damage. Okay, they killed 10 SCVs, but still, you're fine. I think I assume with perfect macro, which you are far away, me too, of course, but you could hit, just to know, in theory, max out right now with 2-2 on the way, I guess. Or maybe even finished, depending. I would say on the way, not finished. But yeah. And then you fight down there, the ramp. Liberator again in the same control group, not sieging up. Oh, traitor mines. And then you move down again with your buy, which is so low. Also, you only have two medivacs here, so definitely you are missing a lot of production. And it's on even upgrades. It's just getting wrecked here.
Yeah, it was already GG. I was just trying to.
Yeah.
Hope that maybe I might be able to get some miracle mines.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see. But sadly, that's not the case. I mean, he's not microing good either. Look at the overmints he has. Holy. That's really not good.
What was that? Yeah, you cut out for a bit.
For a long time. He's just on producing 2-2 now, pile, and he's not doing anything. Back at home. Yeah, I would say definitely macro there. Those barracks are definitely 4 to 5 minutes late.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do you have any questions unanswered currently left? Anything you want to talk about before we end the session?
I think I'm good for now.
Okay. So I did get some notes for you, which I will send you.
Okay.
Marines. Deep forces at all. Get watch towers. Okay. Good, then let me see. Tbbdd, that's that. I just look over it if I got everything. But I guess so far. So from scratch, I would say you have quite good play style and game knowledge. It's just really with the timing. If you the timing of your transition from the 2 base economy to the 3 base economy, I definitely think what league are you? Diamond 3?
Yeah, Diamond 3. Although I haven't really been playing much ranked lately. About a month or two ago, I went on a really really long loss streak, and I got to basically platinum MMR again. So basically started playing only plat, only unranked.
Okay, for a okay. Bit. No, that's okay.
I was playing a lot of other people.
Mm-hmm. I just think this guy, if I remember correctly, was Master League, Master 3 or maybe Master 2, I don't know. So, and you did quite well against him, even with your only 3 barracks so far. So it wasn't the worst I've seen so far. I definitely think if you work on your transition from 2-base to 3-base economy and keep up your current skill level, like microvise and generate vision, snipe, and just every bit getting a little bit better and hit your timings with the transition, you definitely can get into at least Diamond 1, not maybe even Master 3 fairly soon, I would say. So don't get demotivated there or discouraged.
Okay, cool.
You definitely can have it. If you fix that, I guess.
Oh, yes. The other game I played against this guy was a cheesy build. Did you end up watching that one?
On Frozen Temple?
Yes.
Yeah, I did watch it. Shortly. It was... The Widowmine drop was nice, but then at some point you went for the eBay and plus one, while you didn't even have a second command center on the way. I think you were a little bit indecisive or didn't practice this build enough. So either you go full all in.
I haven't practiced it, but the idea is to do damage with the Widow Mines and then follow up with plus one and Stim.
Okay.
And two tanks and two libs.
Okay. Yeah, I think the first lib got sniped, then you dropped the tanks on top of the Adepts and the Immortal. The Marines got wrecked. It was a mess. So either you go full all in, or you go macro behind it, but then you need to decide. I would say if you do this push, grab some SCVs, push a little bit slower, but get the bunker up. And
okay, yeah, I can.
After the two Widow mines, you get the tanks. Maybe get, yeah, tanks are nice, but maybe get just one tank and then a cyclone in case of war press. I don't know. It really depends. Two tanks is fine with lots of marines. But bunker would be handy as well. And what you definitely don't want to do with the, at least what I would say is with this kind of push, you need to test it out. I don't know for sure now if you get enough minerals without using mules to supplement the two racks, the upgrades, the tanks and such. Because if he scouts, he's, you are one base. Not many people are doing it now. But like half a year ago, where I was playing a lot of one base, most people just went into one base DT, and DTs were warped in at 4 minutes 20 seconds. And if you don't have scans or turrets, then you basically instant lose.
Okay.
So at least I know for there is a build where you go cyclone widowmine push. So one cyclone, two widowmines at a time, lift the barracks for vision. And after your first mule, you don't mule at all because you want to snipe observer for the widow mines to be more valuable. And you can supplement this. And I think you need to test it out because I don't know for sure. But maybe the same thing would be good for your push. But if you need the mules, then you need to throw down mules. That's that. I never saw a push like that, to be honest.
Yeah, I've mostly been working on it. I got the opener was from Bian, and then I got a suggestion from Igers, if you know him.
Yeah.
He said that I can make it really dirty by going for the siege tank. He said to build a tech lab and reactor, but I tested it and I couldn't find a way
okay.
to afford the reactor on the starport.
Yeah, I see.
So I just go for slower lib production.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Good.
But yeah, against my level, it basically I haven't lost a game with it. Mm-hmm. That's why I like practicing it against a lot better people.
Okay. No, it's good, I think. On Frozen Temple, it can work. So, yeah.
It's mostly a King Sejong. Build.
I think it can work on KSS, Frozen, and Galactic Process. Maybe Apotheosis as well, but there the rush distance is so far, so you need to proxy faster. And
I wasn't sure if I should, like, I wasn't sure if that build was too counterable when people know how to deal with that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
So I wasn't sure if it was only viable at lower levels.
Mm-hmm.
Because at the moment it wins every game that I use it,
but okay,
I'm not sure
nice.
If that'll actually work when I'm versing good people like that guy.
Yeah, well, you need to try it. I think it can work. Okay, I would end the session then now, if that's okay.
Yeah.
Awesome. Then I wish you best of luck. Keep it up. I would be glad for any feedback if you have some. And if you hit Master League, let me know. And if it didn't help at all, let me know as well. And why, so I can improve for other students. Because I want to get a good coach. Every feedback would be nice.
Okay.
Awesome. Okay.
Yeah, no, it was really helpful.
Nice. Glad to hear that. Okay, then. Oh.
I'll give you updates on how the thing works as I use it and apply it.
Awesome. Okay. Then I wish you a very nice day. Have a good one. Bye.
Have a good one. See ya.
Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye-bye.